Hey everybody! So this is a fun topic today. What to do when your dad yells at you. And I put dad just because that was kind of what my dad used to do to me. But I want to preface this with I love my dad. I love him. I've learned so much from him and he's helped me a ton. But been there, done that. Just like in anything, you guys, we aren't perfect. Sometimes we yell, and this is always a really tough situation because underneath all of the emotions and the yelling or the tough conversations, everyone just cares a lot. And that's why the emotions and everything kind of runs wild. But it still hurts and it's still frustrating in that moment. So here's what you do in this situation. Okay, here's like a few different things that you can work on and do. And take action on, because that's what we're all about, right? Take an action. So number one is be respectful. I know it's going to be so hard. Trust me, I know. But ignoring or rolling your eyes or being rude does not help in this situation. Just know from somebody who's already experienced it. And you've probably experienced it too. Number two, listen, but detach the emotions from the message. Like really try your best to separate and hear what the message is without the anger and the frustration and the negativity. Like figure out what you can learn from your dad or your mom's message that they're saying to you, even though they might be yelling it at you. Number three, know what you can control, okay? You can control your reaction, you can control your attitude, and you can control your interpretation. If you respond and you're like frustrated and angry and you're pouting and like you're taking it out on the rest of the world, you're holding it on to all day, like we're not getting better. And you're just unhappy and that's not fun. So know that what you can control and take advantage of that. Afterwards, when things are settled down a bit, ask your dad or mom to have a conversation so that you can set a boundary. And I'm gonna get into boundaries in just a second. Setting boundaries is crucial because this is something that we use in relationships, okay? Boundaries are for our relationships, whether that's your coach or your parents or your friends or your teammates or your siblings or boyfriends, girlfriends, all like in relationships, we should always have boundaries. And a boundary is there to set, when you set a boundary, it's there to protect you and your confidence, okay? So here's how you set a boundary. You set up that time to talk about setting the boundary. Not when it's in the middle of yelling, not when the emotions are running wild, like a good time when everyone's kind of in a neutral space. And then you're just going to tell that person what you need from them and why you need it. So for example, I need 45 minutes after the game to talk about it so that I can do my own reflection first and then I can share. And you do have to share because you can't just blow your dad off. He wants to be involved. He wants to be a part of it. That's why he's yelling in the first place. Okay. And then the third thing is be consistent with it. And I know that that can be difficult because what if that person doesn't follow your boundary? What if the next time they do the same exact thing? And this is likely to happen because we're human and we forget new habits easily, right? We have to be consistent and practice them in order for the habits to stick. So just keep reminding that person about the boundaries as nicely as you possibly can. And this is going to create a much better, stronger, enjoyable relationship with your parents. So I want you guys to comment below with what boundaries you need to set and what you need from your parents. I can't wait to hear them and see how they start to shift your relationship with your parents and make things much better, especially on those car rides home. But keep on keeping on, and I will talk to you so soon. Bye.